Seniors, wow, what an impact you've made on this great football program. You have left an amazing mark for those that will follow you in the years to come. Your leadership, hard work ethic, willingness to sacrifice for the good of the team are just a few life lessons you guided the underclassmen with over your time. I personally cannot thank you enough for your support, willingness to do what it takes day in and day out, not only to make yourself better, but those around you better. I hope you've learned through your time that whatever obstacle you may face in life, that you will never give up. NGU. I hope the memories of this past season and lessons learned, sometimes the hard way with tough love, will stay with you and guide you as you move on to bigger and better things. Someone shared a story with me by Ann Rulo a few years ago, and I would like to share it with the football class of 2020. A secret of coaches that most people don't know is their deepest fear when a season is low, is that the boys will miss what they need if there aren't enough wins, that they'll get away before they learn what they really need in the end. But one thing we all know, if we live long enough at all, is that some seasons go well and some seasons we fall. Transition and change has found you boys this season. You've worked hard, you've learned much, but still, what is the reason? When you haven't won as many games as you like, tell me, where is the lesson? It's in the grind, my son, is where you find the blessing. Far beyond high school, as your parents all know, maybe days, months, and even years where you don't like how it goes. They've had their own seasons of life that weren't fun. They'll tell you it felt like they lost more than they've won, because results in life don't often come free, and we benefit little from saying, but what about me? So we put on our helmets, we draw up our armor tight. The greatest achievements in life often come with a fight. Football isn't everything, and there's life beyond the score. But the lessons we learn in these years help prepare us for more. So to you, young man, who has shown up every day, the boy who hasn't quit, whose loyalty hasn't strayed, you, my son, are building skills for your life, things that will bless your work, your children, and your wife. When the business you start doesn't take off right away, and your ledger is in the red, and your employees won't stay, you will put in the hours and show up every morning, because in these years of your trial, your perseverance was forming. When your daughter comes home, tears filling her eyes, I really tried my best, Dad, and it still wasn't right. You'll have the words for her to try that test again, because you know what it feels like to have to begin. When your marriage is hard and it would be easy to quit, you will sit in the silence, awkward a bit, yes, a little bit longer than maybe another who hasn't had a season like this with his brothers. Each day you strap up your helmet and cleats, your jersey, your shoulder pads, your socks on your feet. You need these things now, but one day you'll turn them in and football will be over. And that's when you begin to use what you've learned in the seasons high and low, to know how to celebrate and, more importantly, how to grow. And so we pray that you boys get exactly what you need, the lessons that come from wins and from those from defeat. So go forward, young man, with your head held high. This season has been tough, but the future is bright. Thank you for the way that you've played your part. We are proud of your work, the display of your heart. Thank you, football class of 2020. You'll forever be special.